Hello children, we saw in our last class, that is our chapter quadrilaterals. Okay, so we saw about the what is a quadrilateral and what are the types of quadrilaterals and what are the properties of quadrilaterals also, that is a parallelogram, properties of a parallelogram. Okay, so based on that you have a theorem, the properties of parallelograms, all properties you have a like a theorems in your textbook. Okay, but that theorems there is no proof in this year. Okay, so it is excluded in your portion. Okay, so now let us move on to the another part, that is we have a theorem. Okay, that is midpoint theorem. What is the name of theorem? Midpoint theorem. Okay, in a quadrilateral. See, midpoint theorem. So it is very easy theorem. Look at and step first. Okay. So what are the steps? First, we want to write the theorem. The first step, we have to write a statement of the theorem. The statement of a theorem. Then we have to draw the figure. Okay. Then what is given and what we want to prove. Okay. To prove. And then if any construction is there, we can write a construction there. And then we have to prove. Okay. So these are the steps we have to write the theorem. Okay. So first let us move on to the statement of the midpoint theorem. What is the statement? Okay. So let us see. The line segment joining the midpoints of a triangle. Okay. So two sides of a triangle. The line segment, which is the line segment joining the midpoints of a two sides of a triangle. Okay. So let us see. That is a figure. This is a triangle. Okay. So based on this figure, we can write the statement. Okay. So this is a triangle ABC. Triangle A, B, and C. Okay. So the line segment joining two points. Okay. Two points of a two sides of a triangle. So the line segment joining the midpoints. The line segment joining the midpoints of two sides of a triangle. So what is the meaning? The midpoints of two sides of a triangle. The line segment joining, see, the line segment joining that is the midpoints of the two sides of a triangle. Okay, so is parallel to the third side. Here we have here the midpoint, the line segment. See, this is the line segment. The line segment which is joining the midpoints of the two sides of a triangle. Okay, of a two sides of a triangle, is this line segment is parallel to the third side of a triangle. Okay, now we can write the statement. Okay, statement. Now we have to write the statement now. Okay. The line segment. First, the line segment joining the midpoints. The line segment joining the midpoints of two sides of a triangle. See, this is very easy, no? See, the line segment joining the midpoints of a triangle. Okay, two sides of a triangle. The line segment joining the midpoints of two sides of a triangle. So, is parallel to the third side. See, say again with me. See, that is the line segment joining the midpoints of two sides of a triangle is parallel to the third side. Okay, understood now? Okay, so then what is given? So what is given here? A line segment joining the midpoints of two sides of a triangle. So that is given. Okay, so what is given here? A triangle ABC in that E and F. Okay, see, E and F are the line segment which is given. Okay, see, a triangle, a line segment. what is given here, you can write in words. Okay, so that is a line segment joining the midpoints of a triangle. Okay, midpoints of a two sides of a triangle, that is given. Okay, so what is given? A triangle ABC, and here we have our midpoints. Okay, so what is given? Triangle ABC. Okay, triangle ABC is given, and E and F are midpoints. Midpoints. E and F are midpoints of two sides of a triangle. Okay, so that is joining. E and EF is a line segment. EF is a line segment. Okay, it is given. Okay, then to prove. So what we want to prove here? So we want to prove EF is parallel to BC. EF is parallel to BC. So that is parallel to the third side. Which is parallel to the third side? EF. Okay, the line segment EF, which is parallel to the third side BC. Okay, so to prove. And then construction. If there is a construction, we want to write the construction here. It is very important in the theorem. Okay, what is construction here? So draw a line segment through C. Draw a line segment through C. Draw a line segment through C. Okay, so here which is parallel to the side of a triangle AB. So you draw a line segment through C which is parallel to AB. Okay, and then extend the line segment EF that it meets the point D at the line segment C. Okay, so this line segment we are extending. Okay, this it is means at D at the line we are drawing through C. Okay, so now extend, that is draw a line segment CD through C. Okay, draw a line segment AD. Is it right? It is understood, no? Which is parallel to AD. Okay? Then extend EF. Okay? Extend the line segment EF to D. Which is mean at D and the line segment C. Okay? So now this is construction. Okay? And then we have to prove. We have to prove. So we know that is AB is parallel to CD by construction. See, AB is parallel to CD by construction. By construction, we can say AB is parallel to CD. Okay, so AB is parallel to CD means, and we can take ED as a transversal. ED as a transversal. A is parallel to CD by construction, and EB is a transversal. EB is a transversal. Okay, so now we can take ED is a transversal means we can say the alternate angles here. What are the angles? What is the alternate angles here? These two are alternate angles. See, AB is parallel to CD and ED is a transversal. See, AB is parallel to CD and ED is a transversal. Now we can say these two angles are alternate angles. Is it right? Now we can say these two angles are alternate angles. That is AEB and then AED is equals to angle CDB. Okay, by alternate angles. Okay, by alternate angles. So then from this we can compare these two triangles, that is in triangle AEF and triangle CFD. Okay, or CDF, you can take anything. Okay, so AEF AFE equals to, and then CFB. Angle CFB. Okay. So these two are equal. And then we know AF equals to CF. Okay. CAF equals to CF. So why? Because of AF equals to CF. F is the midpoint of AC. Okay. See, F is the midpoint of AC. Okay. So F is the midpoint of AC. So from this we can say, see, what are the three things we have to take by the congruence property? See, this angle, that is based on alternate angles, and AFB equals to CFB, that is vertically opposite angles, and AF equals to FC, that is based on the midpoint of, F is the midpoint of AC. Okay, based on these three properties, we can say these two triangles, triangle AFB and triangle CFB are congruent. Okay, see, that is triangle AEF is congruent to triangle CFB by ASA congruence rule. Okay, ASA congruence rule. So from this we can say ASA congruence rule, we can say the corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. Corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. So here what are the congruent parts? AE equals to CB. AE equals to CB by CP. Okay. So here AE equals to CB means we can say, and that is we know by the midpoint of a triangle, E is a midpoint of a triangle, we can say AE equals to but AE equals to EB. AE equals to AB. Okay, from this we can say EB equals to CD. Is it right? EB equals to CD. See, AE equals to CD, and then we know by the midpoint of a triangle, AE equals to EB. So we can say EB equals to CD. Okay, so from this we can say EB is parallel to CD, and EB equals to CD. So from this one pair of parallelogram are equal and parallel. So we can say that is a parallelogram. Okay. So this is a parallelogram. One pair of opposite sides are equal and parallel. Okay. So from this we can say one pair of opposite sides are equal and parallel. Okay. So and hence we can say EBCD is a parallelogram. EBCD is a parallelogram. See, EBCD is a parallelogram. EBCD is a parallelogram. So EBCD is a parallelogram means we can say these two are parallel. So from this we can say EF is parallel to BC. EF is parallel to BC. That what we want to do now. EF is parallel to BC. See, once again let us see this theorem. Again, the line segment joining the midpoints of two sides of a triangle is parallel to the third side. Okay. So the line segment joining the midpoints of two sides of a triangle which is parallel to the third side. Okay. So given. So what is given here? A triangle ABC is given and the two midpoints of the two sides of a triangle. Okay. So that is given, and EF is the line segment. And then what we want to prove here, that side, line segment EF is parallel to the third side BC. Okay. Construction. Here we want to construct a line segment through C. Okay. Through the vertex C, and we are extending the line segment EF. It means a point D at the line segment which we are construction. Okay. Say that C is parallel to AB and extending EF is parallel EF to D. Okay. So then by construction we can take AB is parallel to CD. So by construction, and EB as transversal we are taken. So from these two concepts we can take an angle, that is AED, which is equal to CBE by alternate angles. Okay, by alternate angles we can say AED is equal to CBE. Okay, so then we can take these two triangles now. Okay, these two triangles. Here we can take these two triangles. have by alternate angles is one property, and another property is vertically opposite angles, and another property is by the midpoint of F. Okay, so we can see AF equals to CE. By these three properties, we can say these two triangles are congruent, and these two triangles are congruent means we can say the corresponding parts are equal. So what is the corresponding parts here? AE equals to CD. AE equals to CD, and then we know by the midpoint of a triangle. Okay, so that is the midpoint of a triangle. AE equals to EB. So we can say from this EB equals to CD, AE equals to CD, and then these two are equal. EB equals to CD. Is it right, my children? So EB equals to CD. Okay. So EB equals to CD means these two are one pair of opposite sides. Okay. So this is one pair of opposite sides, and this is another pair of opposite sides of your parallelogram. Excuse me. So these two are one pair of opposite sides of your parallelogram. So this one pair of opposite sides of parallelogram are equal and parallel. Equal and parallel. So these two are equal and parallel means we can say EBCD is a parallelogram. If one pair of opposite sides are equal and parallel, means the other opposite sides also equal and parallel. So from this we can say it is a parallelogram, and then ED is parallel to BC. So from that we can say EF is parallel to BC. Is it right? Understood, children? Okay. So this theorem is very important. Practice it again and again. Okay. So this is very important theorem for you. Okay. The chapter quadrilaterals. Okay. So based on this, let us see the example problems now. Okay. So you have example 7, page number 131. Okay, 131, page number 131. You have an example problem. Okay, see, keep your textbook with you while watching the video. Okay, so here in a triangle ABC, D, E, and F are respectively the midpoints of the sides AD, BC, and CA. Okay, so what is given here? A triangle ABC. Okay, so a triangle ABC. A triangle ABC. Okay, so here in this, it is given midpoints of sides AB, BC, and CA, that is D, E, F. See, D, E, and F. See, D, E, and F are the midpoints of the triangle ABC. Okay, so show that triangle ABC is divided into four congruent triangles by joining BEF. Okay, so by joining BEF. Okay, so by joining BEF, this triangle ABC has divided into four congruent triangles. We want to prove these four triangles are congruent. These four triangles are congruent. Okay, so here how to prove? That is, it is given here in a triangle ABC, D, E, F are the midpoints of the sides AB, BC, and CD respectively. It is given. Okay. And we can take DF is parallel to BC. DF is parallel to BC. And D is parallel to AC. Okay. So D is parallel to AC. Why? Because these are our midpoints. Okay. D is parallel to AC. And EF is parallel to AB. Okay. That we know by the midpoint theorem. By the midpoint theorem. So these are all midpoints, means we can say that is DE is parallel to AC and DF is parallel to BC and EF is parallel to AB. Okay, by midpoint theorem we know that. So from this similarly, we know these are all the parallel sides. Okay, so then from this we can say that is AD, EF is a parallelogram and BDFE is a parallelogram and DFC is a parallelogram. See how many parallelograms here in this? We have three parallelograms. See, ADEF. See, ADEF is a parallelogram. Okay, ADEF is a parallelogram. And then BDFE is a parallelogram. BDFE is a parallelogram. parallelograms in this triangle we have. Okay, so from this DE is a diagonal. We can take DE is a diagonal of the parallelogram. See in this DE is a diagonal of the parallelogram BDFE. Okay, so DE is the diagonal of the parallelogram BDFE. So in this, this is the diagonal. Means the diagonal divides the two equal triangles of a parallelogram. Okay, two equal sides of a parallelogram. If these two are parallel, so it congruent. Okay, so it divides two equal sides. Means equal sides means these two are equal. Okay, equal means congruent. Okay, so triangle BDE is congruent to triangle BEF by the property of a parallelogram. By the property of a parallelogram. Okay, so here we do not have a proof of the property of a parallelogram. That is, there is no proof for it. Okay, so here you know that is these two triangles. Okay, a diagonal of a parallelogram which divides the parallelogram as two equal parts. Okay, if it divides two equal parts, means the two are congruent. You know that concept. Is it right, children? So these two are congruent. Okay, so now these two are congruent means we can take as the same this two parallelograms. Okay, here we can take these two parallelograms. See ADEF. In ADEF we have taken diagonal as BF. Okay, diagonal as BF, and we can take BFCE. Okay, so in this parallelogram we can take EF as a diagonal. EF as a diagonal. We can take these diagonals. By the diagonal of a parallelogram, it divides a parallelogram into two equal triangles. Okay, that two equal triangles are congruent. So from that we can say all the triangles are congruent. Okay, now let us see ADEF. See ADEF. In this we have two equal triangles, that is congruent. Triangle ADF, which is congruent to triangle DEF. See, now these two are equal, means these two are also equal. Okay, now let us take another parallelogram, that is DFCE. Okay, in DFCE, triangle DEF is congruent to triangle CEF. Okay, so now we can say all the four triangles are congruent. Now a triangle ABC is divided into four congruent triangles. Understood now? By the diagonal of, by the property of a parallelogram, that is the diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two equal triangles. Okay, so then we move on to the another example, example 8. Okay, so L, M and N are three parallel lines. Okay, so here it is given three parallel lines. So three parallel lines, L, M and N are three parallel lines. See, we have this is L and M and N. Okay, we have three parallel lines. So in these three parallel lines, intersected by transversals. Three parallel lines intersected by transversals. How many transversals? Two transversals. What are the two transversals? P and Q are transversals. Okay, so P and Q. P and Q are two transversals. P and Q are two transversals. Okay, so here and then such that L, M and N cut off equal intercepts AP and BC. So equal intercepts AP and BC on P. Okay, AP and AC on P. So from that we can say AP equals to BC. Okay, so this transversal cuts on equal intercepts. Equal intercepts means equal spaces. That is, AB equals to BC. It is given. AB equals to BC. It is given. Okay. And then show that L, M and N cut off equal intercepts BE and EF on Q also. Okay. So what is given here? So AB equals to BC is given. Okay. What we want to prove? Okay. So DEF. DE equals to EF we want to prove. Okay. So these two are equal, these two also equal equal to what to 2 here. Okay. So here that is given. AB equals to BC and AB equals to BC. It is given. Okay. So here given AB equals to BC is given. Okay. And what you want to prove? What you want to prove here? BE equals to EF. We want to prove. BE equals to EF. We want to prove. Okay. So here AB equals to BC and BE equal to EF. We want to prove. And we have to construct here. Construction also there. Construction. What is the construction here? So we want to construct AF. Join AF. Join AF. Okay. So now here this AF is intersect at, this is L, M and L now. So AF is intersects at G at M. Okay. AF intersects G at M. Okay. A line segment M. So this AF is intersects the point G at M. Okay. So M line intersects G at M. Okay. So then we know from this by a triangle ACF. Okay, we have to take a triangle ACF. So here, so this is a trapezium. So what is a trapezium here? ACFB is a trapezium. ACFB is a trapezium. And then in this trapezium can be divided into two triangles by construction. So one is ACF and another one is AFD. Okay. So what are the concepts? It is given in your textbook. So that is example 8. So L, M and N are three line segments. Okay. Three parallel line segments. In this line segments is divided, that is intersects are two transversals. One is P and another one is Q. Okay. And then it is given AB equals to BC. That is the line transversal P. Okay. Intersects the line segments L, M and N at equal intersects. Okay. Equal intersects. That we can say AB equals to BC. And we want to prove Q also same as the equal intersects. It means intersects on the lines L, M and N. Okay. So here we have to construct a line segment, that is joining A and F here. Okay. While joining A and F, it intersects the point G and M. Okay. So we have two triangles in a trapezium ACFD. ACFD is a trapezium. Here we have two triangles, that is ACF and AFD. Okay. So now in this in triangle, so construction join AF. Okay. Then proof. So how to prove? We are taking one triangle first. In triangle ACF. In triangle ACF, we have B as the midpoint. Okay, so B as the midpoint of AB. So B as the midpoint of AC. Sorry, B as the midpoint of AC. So therefore, we can say BG is parallel to F. Okay, BG is parallel to CF. BG is parallel to CF. See, B is midpoint of AC. So therefore we can say BG, this line segment BG is parallel to CF, the third side of a triangle. Why we can say B is midpoint but BG is parallel, what we don't know now. So how we can say? Why? Because of F. So here we know B is a midpoint of CF. Okay. Sorry, B is a midpoint of AC. B is a midpoint of AC. But we know that BG is parallel to CF. BG is parallel to CF. Why? Because we can say BG is parallel to CF. Why? Because of the line. Excuse me. The line segments M and N are parallel. The lines M and N are parallel. Okay. We are taking three line segments. The three line segments are parallel. So we can say BG is parallel to CF because of six. M is parallel to N. Okay, M is parallel to N. So these two are, that is BG is parallel to CF means, we can say G is the midpoint of AF. Is it actually? AF, midpoint of AF. Okay, J is the midpoint of AF. And then we are taking triangle, in triangle AFB. Okay, in triangle AFB, G is the midpoint of AF by this. Okay, so by we proved above law. So G is the midpoint of AF. So G is the midpoint of AF means we can say G is parallel to AB. G is parallel to AB. Therefore, we can say GE is parallel to AB. So why? Because of you know M is parallel to L. Okay, is it right? Since M is parallel to L, so we can say that is G is parallel to AB means we can say E is the midpoint of DF. Okay, so E is the midpoint of DF. So E is the midpoint of DF means we know that is T is parallel to D is equals to EF. Okay, so E is the midpoint of DF means we can say D equals to EF. That is, we can say DE equals to EF. Okay, next proof. Okay, so that is given the concept, state first. So what are the three lines in this? LM and NR parallel lines. Okay, so P and Q are transversal of these two three parallel lines. That is given this transversal P as intersects these three lines at equal intercepts. Equal intercept means we can take AB equals to BC, and we want to prove the transversal Q also divides these three line segments at equal intercepts. Okay, so understood students? So that you prove by the construction. What is construction here? AF, you join AF and you can divide this trapezium ACFP into two triangles, and then you prove by the midpoint theorem. By using a midpoint theorem, you can set proof. Okay, so understood students? Based on this, we have a exercise problem. Okay, so exercise 7.2, you have 7 problems in this. I will send the notes through WhatsApp. Okay, so before that, you try this problems in your rough notebook and try it yourself. Then I will send the notes through WhatsApp. Continue. Okay, cross check your answers and write down neatly in your classwork. Okay, children. So then only you can